Hello guys, welcome to Flying the Bears with an Aurora Journey 53. Today I am testing the ARGO RAFT Howler in the IAE PTU 3.17.4, and let's see how this ship is. Okay, here you can see it. It's for me this is a medium freighter. It has 96 SEUs of cargo capacity. It's pretty nice. Here are the technical specs. It's big, as you can see. 40 meters length, 10 meters wide, 12 meters of height. It can have two crew members. It has two beds. That's also nice because you can log out inside the ship. Here you can see that it has one weapon and two turrets, and also it has medium shields. This is also good, but the most important thing is of this ship is the cargo capacity, 96 SEUs. There are no technical data regarding the thrusters or the speed of it, but well, I have tested it. And you will see that this its speed is nice. It's not very high, but it's nice. So, well, I don't know why there are no technical specs on the speeds. Have no idea. Another thing that is nice from this ship is that you can go inside using the elevator, but you cannot go outside using the elevator. There is an airlock, so to go outside you have to open the airlock and then go outside. This is good for safety, so it is nearly impossible that someone can steal your ship, because they won't be able to jump to the airlock. You have to jump from the airlock to the ground. There is no ladder, so it's safe. As you can see, the elevator only works from the outside, not from the inside. And this is nice. I don't know if it's a bug or it's just or they have made it on purpose for safety reasons. I was trying to go down with the elevator, but it didn't allow me, so I think it's made on purpose. Here is the quarter deck. You will see two beds and a dining room. It's nice. The interior is nice. 96 SEUs of cargo. For example, if you are doing quantanium mining, you can load three full batches of quantanium here, so it's nice. It has a turret, so you can defend yourself if you have a second crew member. And as you will see, it's not very fast, but it's not that bad.
You are clear to launch.
I also I like the stability of the ship. As you will see, the landing gear in this case is well designed. Previously, I tested a miscellaneous Hulley, and I didn't like the landing gear design, because it makes the ship to be unstable when you land. In this case, the landing gear is properly placed. It's properly.
Landing gear
Thank you. And please visit again.
Okay, as you see, the speed is not bad. maneuverability is also not bad, taking into account that this is a howler. Of course, my preferred ship for howling right now is the C2 Hercules, but this ship is good. 96 SEUs is a good amount of cargo. And as you will see, as always, I will fly in the couplet mode when I arrive at the moon, and it was pretty easy to control the ship, so the feeling when you are flying is nice. I also like the design, the industrial design that this ship has. It looks very industrial. I like also the orange display. It's easy to see all the data with that color when compared with the colors of the background, so I like this color. The only thing I don't like is the reservoir, it's very little. As you can see, we have nearly used 25% of our hydrogen capacity, so it's very little, but well. Right now it doesn't matter because the cost of hydrogen is really low, but I don't know in the future how this cost will affect to doing howling and trading. The more capacity you have, the less time you lose refueling. So is for that. As you can see, I am playing in the couplet mode, and it behaves pretty well. I am limiting my speed because the ship is big. But as you can see, it is easy to handle it. Just be careful with the speed, and with vertical speeds also be very careful. But it's easy. It's nice. Now you will see. You will see when I land why I like the landing gear, because it gives stability to the landing. I also like the voice of the onboard computer. It's like an Android voice, very metallic. Metal voice. And yeah, it's at low speeds, it handles really, really good. Look at this, it's beautiful. I like this because it looks very industrial and very robotic also. And look at the landing gear, the four points of contact with the ground at the edge of the ship. So this is really, really stable. and I like it too. From an engineering point of view, it's a good design. Now you will see that to get out of the ship, I will use the airlock. It's near the cockpit, so it's very easy to get out. It's safe because there is no ladder, there is no elevator to get out. Nobody will be able to storm inside of your ship and steal it. It will be more difficult, of course. They could be waiting here with a ship at this height and jump in, but it's not that easy, and you will notice that there is a ship in the landing pad, so... And as you have seen, the door has closed really, really fast, so... I like this kind of safety. Especially because in the next patch, on December 2022, with the cargo lift factor, the guys like me that like to trade and do howling will be facing more problems regarding piracy, so it's nice. As you will see, I wasn't able to have a full load of Arisium. That's a pity. In theory, it should be easy to get 96 SCUs of Arisium, but there were not enough, so, well. I was only able to carry 76, I think. So well. Now I will go back to New Babbage, to the Commons, and we'll sell to the TV to avoid using ground transports, ground trams, ground trains, or ground shuttles. Because for me it's a lose of time. It's a risk, of course, because you are not landing at a spaceport and storing the ship. You just land at the Commons, and at the Commons you cannot store the ship. But you avoid train rides. So, I like this ship. It's nice. It has more cargo capacity than a Freelancer Max, for example, so I like it. You cannot carry any ground vehicles on it, but well, for doing howling and trading is good. For doing Quantanium howling is also good, because 3 batches of Quantanium, it's a good amount of money. 96 SUs of Quantanium. It's nice. So for me the most important features of this ship is landing gear stability, 96 SUs of cargo, and that it has 2 beds. This is the most important thing for me of this ship. So it's suited for making trading in the Microtech area. You don't have to move from Microtech planet, so you can use the ship, and also for Quantanium howling. And as you can see, it moves pretty well. The booster does not last for a big amount of time, but it can help you to gather some speed. And as you can see, atmospheric speed is not bad. And I like also the noise of the ship. Maneuverability is not very, very good, as you can see. But the speed is good, so it's a howler. Okay, now we are at the commons. New badge. I am using the booster to compensate for the atmospheric friction. I am flying in the coupled mode now. Flying in the coupled mode, you have a feeling on how the ship behaves, especially in atmospheric flight. And if you are flying with mouse and joystick, you have more control flying this way, and it's more challenging, it's more fun. And as you can see, atmospheric maneuvering is not very good. The speed is good, but the maneuvering is not good. The speed is low, but well, it's a howler, so. And this ship that you see in front of us is a new ship. It's a Drake Corsair. I will try to make a video also testing that that ship. It has, as you can see, the Drake Corsair has vertical winglets. I don't know why. Maybe for maybe it's for holding weapons. It's possible, but that is for holding weapons. Mm-hmm. Oh, there is another one too. One have just landed. Two Draycors. They are new ships. That's why there's a lot of people testing them. Here you will see that there is a cat in the video because there was a 30k. But well, I was able to return here, the ship was still here, and I was able to sell the cargo. So I didn't lose my investment. So for me, this ship is good. It's good. 96 SCUs, nice speed, two beds, two red, some weapons, one weapon. So it's nice. I like this airlock. And here you will see that I am selling now the cargo. Not a full load because there was not enough aggression, but well, it's nice. And as always, at the end, the profits we have made, and that's it. Have a nice one, and see ya, guys.